reception that you got from the fans when you hit that shot in the fourth quarter. What was that moment like to be serenaded by the fans that called a timeout and then you obviously hear even louder?
I mean, it's of course a nice moment. Nice. I'm going to remember that probably my whole life. It's a nice, nice. I just loved how they treat me and how they like they're really on my side, and I just love Nuggets fans. They're always on my side, and they was always bringing the energy that we need.
Can you take me inside what happened with the headband? Whose idea was it, and what did you think?
I think it was Jason or Dan, and I think Jason know that I don't want to wear it, and then I went out the first time, and then it started bleeding. Then I needed to put it just to, if it's a little bit bleeding, so I can just take it. It's gonna go to the headband, so it was nice.
Will you continue to wear it?
No. I look great. I cannot let you guys see in that twice.
Nicole, you guys clinched a playoff spot for the fourth time. What does it mean for the consistency of this team, and just how much adversity you guys have?
I think, like I said, since I came, I think we are every year we are better and better. This year, even through the injuries, even to the guys not playing, we still made the playoffs. And in the playoffs, everything can happen, you know. So we need to prepare ourselves. There is a lot of time to that, and we need to be ready for the game one.
Cole Malone said when he left you in the game to start the fourth quarter, in his head he was thinking, just score so I can get you out of there. Were you approaching? I know you don't often look to score. Did that affect your approach at all? Were you looking just to get in, get 2 points, and get out?
That was the plan, and then they started doubling me, so I was just passing out the ball. And then in a moment, I'm just going to shoot it. If I make, if I don't make, I'm going to go on the bench. So in that moment, we were up 30 or something. So I took that fade away from the left, right corner. I missed, so I was good. So.
Well, for years. We would ask you about being the best player on this team. You always had that comment. So I don't know about that. And you're considered one of the best players in the NBA. You're doing things that no one has accomplished. Has your view on that, the time you spent also around these other guys, competing at the level of the playoffs, has your perspective on your place in the history of the game changed at all?
To be honest, I think that there is a lot of guys that are playing on an extremely high level right now in NBA. And there you can see how talented the league is. There is a bunch, literally like 20 players that can be like superstars, you know. So I'm just trying to be humble, to stay on the ground. Do I see in one of the best? Yes and no. I think to be the best, you need to have a better record, to be honest. Do I impact the game? I think that I impact the game really well on different occasions. How you say, different ways. So, I mean, I don't think about that, to be honest. I'm one of the best in the league. I'm just trying to win the game. You know, that's my approach.
Nicole, you've always been very humble about the MVP conversation, but every single coach, every single teammate has advocated for it. So I'm curious if you've ever thought about what it means. Not just for you, but for the entire team, perhaps even the city of Denver and the Nuggets, that you win the
end. I mean, to be honest, I don't know it. I don't know. I mean, I won it last year. Did I see some kind of different? To be honest, no. But I'm just. I think I have a great season. The whole season. I'm even better than last year. So. If that is enough, it's enough. If it's not, I mean, you cannot control that. So if they're going to give you, they're going to give you. So.
How much of a relief is it to make the playoffs outright, to clinch that, and not have to worry? The players have said some various things about the play-in. How stressful has it been kind of being concerned about potentially falling the play-in?
I mean, of course, because it's one game. You know, you can have bad shooting night. You can have one guy get injured, or the... They're just going to run, and then the nervous, the atmosphere, maybe, who knows? It's something that definitely you don't want to be there. And I'm really happy that we don't need to go there, and we can prepare ourselves to the playoffs.
Nicola, coach talked after the game about the fact that if you're not taking time to enjoy the victories, then why are you even doing this? And he means that for everybody. Are you going to take a second to kind of step back and be proud of your accomplishments, or are you right onto the playoffs at this point?
To be honest, I'm not going to lie. My brother had a baby last night, so I'm really happy about it. So that's my thoughts are going. So I just want to see my niece for the first time. So I think basketball is important, and there is a bunch of things that are more important than basketball. So yes, victory is nice, but I think there is better victories in real life, let's say something like that, you know. So I'm just happy that my niece is okay, and they're actually I think they're home right now, so hopefully I'm gonna see them. Maybe I don't think so today, but tomorrow.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I
think Felipe is gonna sell that on eBay. He took the headband. I think he told me that he's gonna sell it on eBay. We can maybe split the money. Who knows? Maybe it's worth a lot. But I just get the ball people to sign, because it's not just my thing. Yeah, I think it's a collective effort. Like I said, I think the team put me as a leader is in front of them. So without them, I couldn't do it. You know.
Are you a Sierra fan? Russell Wilson.
Oh, I feel bad. I don't follow.
Okay.
I don't know. Hopefully, yeah. I mean, I'm at them in the hallway, so I'm feeling bad because it's not my music. I don't even listen to American music. So, I mean. I'm gonna listen and then I'm gonna let you guys know.
Nicola, do you know Russell Wilson, or were you aware?
Yeah, yeah, I knew it. I don't know how he plays, but I knew who he is.
Nicola, what was that moment like in the hallway here where Tim gave you the game ball and a hug after?
What he told me? I'm not gonna lie, he told me something funny, but I forgot.
Nothing that
no, it was real actually. It was funny. Oh, he told me like he stinks like horses. I said, "Don't worry, I'm used to it," because he was in Europe scouting. So I just told him, "Don't worry, I'm used to it." He said something more, but I cannot remember, brother. My bad.
Nikola, čestitamo, čuli smo da je ovo fantastično veče upotpunjeno i što je tvoj brat je tako dobio ćerku. Čestitamo prvo na tome. Ja bih rekao, evo mislim da to prvi kažem, ti si košarkaški Nikola Tesla. Kao što je on genij u nauci, ti si genij u košarci. Prvi igrač u istoriji NBA s 2000 poena, 1000 skokova, 500 asistencija u jednoj sezoni. Večeras obezbedili ste ulazak u play-off, dvoranom se rolilo MVP, a u sve to na početku su ti raskrvali glavu, ne znam, na početku utakmice. Kako je bilo?
Pa dobro je. Drago mi je. Hvala prvo na čestitkama za rođenje bratove ćerke. Mislim da je to nešto najvažnije, da se porodica širi, da se uveličava i da se množi i samo da ide gore. Što se tiče utakmice, sjajna utakmica za nas. Eto, osvojili smo play-off ove godine po četvrti put uzastopce. Pobedili smo ekipu koja nas je pobedila tri puta, jeste fali im par igrača, fali nama, tako to ja uvek kažem, tako da ne obraćam pažnju ko ne igra nego ko igra. Eto, imamo 7 dana, mislim se pripremamo za play-off utakmicu, sad ne znamo i ko će, možda i znamo, samo ja ne znam. Tako da to drago mi je što smo i ove godine uspeli da napravimo play-off, tako da eto, nadamo se da ćemo da ostvarimo nešto.